Hello, Valley Mills Christian Church friends and family. I hope you all are doing well, staying safe and healthy. I know these are trying times. I know these are unprecedented times. And I know, as Bob and many of others have said, is that we haven't really faced anything like this in our lifetimes. So I hope to start off this week with giving you all an encouraging message, just for you all to think about and to just ponder. And my hope for you guys is to just to put your hope and trust in God through these times. So I'd like to give an example from the Old Testament, and I wanted to focus on this theme of enduring faith and what that means, to have faith through trying times where we don't know what the outcome is going to be. And I'd like to share a little bit of the story of Esther, a little bit of a summary of what happens in her life and how God used her. So in this time, the Jews were being oppressed, and Esther was actually brought into the king's harem. Now you might imagine what was going through her mind at this time. How is God going to be able to use her? But like I said, there is a time of oppression. Haman, who was a man, was the king's secondhand man, just put out a lot of hate and oppression towards the Jewish people. And Esther, at this time, came to approach her uncle Mordecai, who was suffering quite badly. And he gives her an encouraging and uplifting speech, inspires her to trust in God, that he is going to use her in this time of uncertainty, to bring their people out of this oppression. And Esther actually gains the favor of the king, and the king tells her that he'll give her whatever she wants. And she actually, at the end of the story, God used her to lift this oppression off of the Jewish people, which I think was a very inspiring and encouraging story, that although in this time of just oppression and uncertainty, and she had enduring faith in God, that he had everything in control. I'd also like to share from the New Testament how Paul and Silas, when they were thrown into prison, and you know, Paul had gone through prison a lot of times in his life. But in this specific story of when Paul and Silas were in there, imagine what they were thinking, like, oh, this could be the last time, you know, or, you know, maybe this is just the condition of their existence. And what did? They started singing and worshiping and praising God. And soon after that, there was an earthquake and their shackles fell off. And I know for a lot of us, when we're going through something, I know loneliness can be one of those shackles in our lives right now. I know just a lack of having a support system around us to support us through these times may be our shackles, or maybe just being confined just in your homes and feeling like you can't leave may be a form of those shackles. But I know that from Paul and Silas's example, and from taking the example of all those who have gone before us in the faith and have given us those good examples, to take after them and to worship God and to praise him and to pray to him and to ask him for help in these times of need. And I just want to encourage you through this. And I'd like to just put in here as well, if you guys need anything, if you have my number or if you don't have my number, you can find that in Breeze, which is our church database, basically our online directory for our church. You can find my phone number and my email, or you can find that on the website. Just feel free to send me prayer requests and I'll pray for you, or call me and I'll pray with you. I will not shy away from that. I plan on reaching out to a lot of you throughout this week as we go forward. I just want to be there for you as your shepherd, as your just worship minister. I want to be a minister to you all, and I want to make sure you all are doing okay. I'd like to end this video with a scripture from Habakkuk, and it's from the third chapter and verse 17 through 19. It's the third chapter. I don't know if I got that right, but the first time. But I'd like to preface this with Habakkuk was foreseeing this oncoming doom and destruction from the Babylonians onto his people of Judah. And so this was before this was all going to happen, but Habakkuk could see it coming. And you can imagine what he was feeling at this time, you know, these times of uncertainty. And yet he writes this, and this is the part that I'm going to share with you. Even through these difficult times and this anguish that he must have been feeling, he writes this. Okay, verse 17 of chapter 3. Though the fig tree should not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, the produce of the olive fail, and the fields yield no food, the flock be cut off from the fold, and there be no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will take joy in the God of my salvation. God the Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the deer's. He makes me tread on my high places. And so this passage right here was very encouraging to me. I hope it is for you all as well. But even though we may not know what all is going to happen, or maybe we know what's going to happen and we don't see how God is going to work things out, we are to take this example to put our trust, put our faith in God, that knowing full well that he has everything in his control and that he works all things out for good. We want to thank God. We want to rejoice in God. We want to put our joy in God, or put our hope and our trust in him and our faith in him, because he is faithful and he is steadfast in his faithfulness. And he is the hope that we can hold on to through these tough times. So I hope this was encouraging. I'd like to end this video with a prayer. So let's pray. Dear God, we come to you today in these times of just uncertainty. And God, we thank you for all that you are. We thank you for your steadfastness, and we thank you for your faithfulness. And we thank you for your son, Jesus, his life, death, and resurrection, and our hope of eternal life with you. God, we know that scripture says that after all of this passes away one day, God, that we have the hope of your enduring love and your enduring faith. And God, we look forward to that. God, I pray that as we, in this present moment, through this time, that we can be a light for you, to those who don't know you yet. God, I pray that we may be the salt of the earth, to bring life to this world. And God, I pray that the faith of those who are putting their trust in you, that they may be strengthened and encouraged and uplifted. God, we thank you so much for all that you have given us. And I pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen.